So as many of you know from my past few videos, I'm currently in the process of setting up an email list for one of my websites. Now, as this is the first time I've ever done anything like this, I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be making quite a few mistakes in the process. No doubt that some of you are probably doing the exact same thing with your websites. So in the video today, I'm gonna go through the exact 3 steps that I'm following at the moment to hopefully build up a successful email list on my website. So let's jump into it. So step number one is just gonna be to come up with a lead magnet. Now I've actually gone into a fair bit of detail on what a lead magnet actually is in last week's video, but just to summarize here very, very quickly, a lead magnet is just basically a cheat sheet, an ebook, an infographic, whatever it might be, basically something that you put on your website that will entice people to give you their email address, usually solving a quick problem that they might be having. For example, if your website is in the car niche, it might be a cheat sheet quick guide on how to replace the car battery there, something as simple as that. Now I've actually completed this step on my website and the lead magnet that I've decided to use is a quick cheat sheet, mainly because from what I've read, you wanna make sure that the cheat sheet is as quick and as easy to digest as possible. You don't wanna have heaps of information that you're throwing at your readers there. So something quick and easy for them to read. One thing though that helped me massively actually when I was coming up with the lead magnet was just to look at your competitors. So see what your competitors are offering on their websites, what freebies they're giving away, what they're using to entice people to give them their email addresses, all those kinds of things, and basically come up with ideas like that as well. So definitely helps. So once you've come up with the lead magnet, step number two is gonna be as simple as placing the lead magnet on your website. So how do we do this? Well, we basically want to come up with an email capture form. An email capture is just basically a form that a reader for your website would just fill in to basically access the content that you're promoting. Think of the many, many websites you visited this past month or so, and I'm sure you've had a couple of pop-ups or a couple of forms that they've suggested for you to fill in there. Basically, that's what email capture is. Now, in terms of where to place your email capture forms, I'm gonna have one above the fold, so at the top of the post, at the bottom of the post, in the sidebar as a sticky, and then also after about 5 or 10 seconds of someone visiting the website, I'll also have it as a pop-up there as well. Now, I know you're probably thinking you have to do this all yourself, but don't worry about it, guys. There's a fantastic plugin out there called Hustle. Alex over at WP Eagle actually talked about this quite a lot in a video, which I'll link in the description box down below. Go through the full tutorial on it, so definitely check that video out. So the final step is just to basically set up email management. So the first 2 steps are fantastic for, you know, promoting that content, getting those initial emails in. But once you've got those emails, you're gonna need to manage them, right? And I'm guessing you definitely don't wanna be using an Excel doc or a Google doc for that, because that's overwhelming just thinking about. This then is when email providers like MailChimp or Sendinblue basically come in. These systems then will allow you to see how many emails you've collected, what type of people they are, and then eventually allow you to send out newsletters, general emails, promoting info products and affiliate products there as well. When your email list becomes big enough to actually manage all that kind of stuff, because there's no point sending it out when you have 2 or 3 people on there, right? Now, in terms of full transparency here, guys, I'm gonna start out using the free options, mainly because your boy has absolutely 0 people on his email list at this moment in time. But then again, I'll move up to more paid services when the email list does grow and obviously you hit the limits and all those kinds of things with these pricing options. I'm also not gonna be sending out too many offers or too many emails to the people on my email list when I first get them, because, you know, like we mentioned earlier on, there's no point in doing it if you only have 20 people on your list. What I'll do is I'll maybe do this for a year or two, try and hopefully grow that email list around about 7,000 to 8,000 people, and then start promoting it with offers there. But it's a lot easier said than done, and as we know with blogging, everything that can go wrong probably will go wrong. So there you have it, blogging family. Those are my quick steps to setting up an email list on my website. Please leave a comment down below. Let me know if you've done the same. And as always, if you are interested in more videos around, you know, blogging, side hustles, personal development, sales, any of that malarkey, absolutely smash the like and subscribe button. It genuinely really does help out the channel. And I'll leave it there for now, guys. See you next week. All the best. Have a good one.